intrafollicular T-cells, particularly CD4 cells, have been shown to be really important. And what that exactly is the immune system responds to the tumor, but it responds by generating a number of different cells. So specifically, CD4 cells help CD8 cells target the tumor in a more effective fashion. So what we found in follicular lymphoma, when looking at lots of different immune cells, some CD4, some CD8, macrophages, we were trying to see what predicts for patients that unfortunately have their disease get active early and progress soon. And we found that actually CD4 cells are critical for preventing patients from progressing and keeping them in remission. And we also then look to see, well, are those just any CD4 cell anywhere, or is the CD4 cell really in the malignant follicle interacting with the tumor? And we actually found that the more CD4 cells you have right in the malignant follicle, the less likely you are to have disease progression and the more likely you are to stay in remission, suggesting that if your immune system is active and going after the tumor, it's going to help protect you from the tumor progressing. But more than just looking globally at CD4 cells, we try to drill in a little deeper to say, well, what exactly is that CD4 cell? What kind of CD4 cell is it? So using some new technologies, CyTOF being one of them, we looked at lots of different markers on the cells and showed that these cells are memory cells, and these cells are activated cells that really appear to be not exhausted, so in other words, in good shape. And then we used a different technology called CODEX, where we tried to prove and showed that it's those particular cells with all those characteristics are in the malignant follicle. So I think how this then translates to the real world is we integrated that into the Flippy, and we kind of called it the bio-Flippy, if you like. And the Flippy is the, using clinical characteristics, the predictor of outcome. And we showed that the bio-Flippy actually does a better job of predicting early progression. So we think that for the future, using the number of CD4 cells that are in the malignant follicle, along with clinical characteristics, will give us a better idea of who's going to do well and who's going to do less well with follicular lymphoma.